Hello friends, now we are going to study voltage regulation for short transmission line. So we have seen that the voltage regulation for short transmission line, general voltage regulation is given by percentage V regulation is equal to VR no load minus VR full load upon VR full load into 100%. So we saw that this will be magnitude, all of it. So if you are to write, so what we wrote, that is VS upon A minus VR upon VR into 100%. So this is the percentage voltage regulation. So we need to find out the value of A. So A value was 1, we calculated. So simply it would be Vs minus Vr upon Vr into 100%. So now we are going to find out for the short transmission line. What we have seen that, if we have seen, like, let us assume Vr is taken as the reference. If Vr is taken as the reference and Ir is taken as the lagging current, means Ir is lagging Vr by an angle of phi r. So what we calculated, that Vr plus R into Ir, Vr plus R into Ir plus J into IXL. So this was your VS. This was your VS. Now what we are going to do, we are going to simplify. We are going to move all of the phasor diagram across this axis. So if you will move this across this axis, so I'm drawing here, that is IR will be represented like this. This is IR and this is VR, and an angle of phi r in between them. So this is Vr plus R into Ir, R into Ir plus Ir into XL, Ir into XL. So Ir into XL, Ir into XL, basically this is 90 degree. So this would be equal to simply Vs. So what we have done, we just move across this axis without changing anything. So this is Vr basically. So now what we are going to do, we are going to take the horizontal axis. Horizontal component will be equal to Vr into cos of phi r up to here, and from here to here this is R into Ir. So same, and this value basically this will be Vr into sine of phi r basically, and this value has been given as Ir into XL in the given diagram. So now we are going to apply the Pythagoras theorem. In Pythagoras theorem, we know that Vs square, all of the values or magnitude, so I am not writing here, I will write at the end of the derivation, Vs square will be equal to Vr cos of phi r plus R into Ir whole square plus Vr sine of phi r plus Ir into XL whole square. So what we will do, we are gonna just square these term. So this, from where we will calculate, Vs square is equal to Vr square cos square phi r plus this second one R square into Ir square plus 2 into multiplication of both Vr into Ir into R cos phi r plus here second one, that will be Vr square sine square phi r plus Ir square into XL square plus 2 times of Vr into Ir XL sine of phi r. So this is the whole equation. So now we are going to write in the second step, that is Vs square is equal to, Vs square is equal to this value, and this value would be taken as 1, and Vr square simply we can write that, because we know that sine square phi r plus cos square phi r would be equal to 1, plus I am taking common as Ir square into r square plus xl square. So this second point, has been completed. Now one point, that is if we are taking common as 2vr into ir, so what we can get, r cos of phi r plus xl sine of phi r. So this is we got. Now what we can write from here, that if you want to write vs square, so now what I'm going to, vr square I'm going to take common, so this will become 1 plus ir square r square plus xl square upon vr square plus 2 into ir upon vr, basically r of cos of phi r plus xl of sine of phi r. So from here what we can see is we can neglect this value. Basically what we can do is we can neglect this value because we know that the value of vr square is much greater than ir square r square plus xl square. This has been, this assumption has been given in the book, and right now I'm only writing this thing, okay? And if you will solve any question by numerically, so ir square r square plus xl square would be very less compared to vr square. I have proved this point, so do not need to worry. So what we can write is that the vs square will be equal to vr square 1 plus 2 into ir upon vr in bracket r cos phi r plus xl sine of phi r. So what we can do in the, from here, that I'm writing here above, so vs, what I can write, vs I can write vr root over means 1 plus 2 into ir upon vr, this is the, into r of cos of phi r plus xl of sine of phi r to the power 1/2, because we have taken the under root. So now from this point what we can write is vs will be equal to vr, this we know that by this formula, that 1 plus x to the power half will be equal to 1 plus x by 2 plus so on. I do not know the other value, but I know definitely that these two values which are required from here. So what we can write is 1 plus 2 into x, so 1/2, so this will be 1 upon 2 into ir upon vr r cos phi r plus xl sine of phi r. So this we can write like this. So 2 cancel out. What we can write from here, that Vs is equal to Vr 1 plus what, Ir upon Ir into, this is the large bracket, R cos phi R plus XL sine of phi R divide by this r. So now what we are going to do, we are just writing the value, this vr here, so vr we are gonna multiply, then this will be cancelled out. So vs is equal to vr, but we can, vs is equal to vr plus, this will be cancelled out, so vs is equal to vr plus ir into r of cos of phi r plus xl of sine of phi r. So vs minus vr, basically I am now applying the mod, because whatever the value I have been written in the phasor diagram, that would be mod I have discussed earlier. So vs minus vr is equal to what we can write, ir into r of cos of phi r plus xl of sine of phi r. So we know the percentage voltage regulation, will be equal to vs minus vr upon vr, upon Vr into 100%. So correspondingly, when we'll write this formula, so it will be Ir upon Vr simply R cos of phi R plus XL sine of phi R into 100%. Always remember into 100% because we are writing in percentage. So this is the formula of voltage regulation. So this is for the lagging load. This is for the lagging load. And now if we will be having leading load, so what we can write? Percentage voltage regulation will be equal to IR upon VR, R cos phi R plus XL sine phi R. We know that the value of sine phi R will be negative for leading power factor. So what we are going to replace this with minus. Always remember, we are going to replace this with minus. So here it will be minus. So percentage voltage regulation is equal to IR upon VR into R cos phi R minus of XL sine phi R into 100%. So this is the formula for lagging load and this is the formula for leading load. Now we are going to find out the maximum voltage regulation. And zero voltage regulation. So since we are going to observe with the help of the formula, we know that for lagging power factor, percentage voltage regulation will be equal to this IR upon VR in bracket R of cos of phi R plus XL of sine of phi R into 100%. And for this zero voltage regulation, this is the case of lagging power factor. So we know that this R will never be negative, cos phi R will be never be negative, XL would never be negative, sine phi R is never be negative in case of lagging power factor. So whenever we are going to talk about the lagging power factor, there we will mention always maximum voltage regulation. And now whenever we are going to talk about the leading load or zero voltage regulation, we are going to put the formula V regul. Percentage voltage regulation is equal to IR upon VR in bracket R cos of phi R minus XL sine of phi R into 100%. So this is the case of leading power factor. If you can see here that directly we will write the value of zero here in case of voltage regulation, so we can find out the relation value. So from maximum voltage regulation, what we can see that this, whenever maximum voltage regulation comes, we are going to talk about the lagging power factor, lagging load means I'm writing here the lagging load. I'm writing here lagging load for maximum voltage regulation and leading load for zero voltage regulation. So this is the point to be remember. So now we are going to talk about the relation at what condition this D percentage of V voltage regulation upon D phi R will be equal to zero. It means for maximum condition. So whenever we are going to differentiate this, so D percentage V regulation upon D phi R value will be equal to this IR upon VR will be same because this is not varying. Only varying is R cos phi R. So cos phi R, the differentiation of that will be minus of R sine phi R plus XL sine phi R, means XL of cos of phi R into 100%. So from here we can see that this, for the maximum voltage regulation, we know that dV regulation upon d phi R will be equal to zero. And when we are going to put this value, we are going to find out R of sine of phi R is equal to xl of cos of phi of r. So from here we can find out tan of phi r will be equal to xl upon r. So phi r we can calculate, phi r will be equal to tan inverse xl by r. So this is the case when maximum voltage regulation. And now we are going to find out the for the zero voltage regulation. So now I am writing here for zero voltage regulation, for zero voltage regulation, simply put zero. So zero is equal to, simply what we are getting is r cos phi r is equal to xl of sine of phi r. So what we are going to write, that is tan phi r is equal to r by xl. So phi r, what we can calculate, phi r we can calculate tan inverse r by xl. So tan inverse r by xl, so these are the opposite, but see the concept that whenever we are going to talk about the maximum voltage regulation, we are going to talk about the lagging power factor, and whenever we are going to talk about the zero voltage regulation, we are going to talk about the leading load or leading power factor. So the power factor angle phi r will be equal to tan inverse xl by r in case of lagging power factor or maximum voltage regulation, and phi r is equal to tan inverse r by xl in case of zero voltage regulation. Why we took this phi r as a differentiating quantity? Because the load is variating. The transmission line, once established, will not change, only change will be in load, and we are going to take the change in load, that is phi r. So the angle will be changing, so leading and lagging load will be changing, and now with the help of differentiation we got the two condition, that is in the case of maximum voltage regulation, this phi r will be equal to tan inverse xl by r, and if for the zero voltage regulation, phi r will be equal to tan inverse r by xl. So here it is all about the formula, and now we are going to solve one short numerical in this topic too. So I am not taking any other topic for this question, because this question is easy as well as small. So the given question is, a transmission line resistance and reactance are equal, means R is equal to XL has been given. Then for maximum and zero voltage regulation, the power factor of the loads will be. First of all, if you are talking about the maximum voltage regulation, then the first it will be lagging. So these two options are wrong, because in this leading and leading has been given. So this two option can be correct. So now we have been written that the maximum voltage regulation phi r will be equal to tan inverse xl by r. So tan inverse xl by r means tan inverse 1, that is 45 degree. So the cos phi r will be equal to cos of 45 degree, means 1 upon root 2, that is coming out to be 0.707 lagging. Why lagging? Because first we are talking about the maximum voltage regulation, and for zero voltage regulation it will be leading. So option C is correct. So this is all about the voltage regulation for short transmission line. Thank you.